Morning. Look at this thing. How's everybody today? Wonderful. You know, we're a teaching that holds that there is an intelligence that exists throughout the universe that acts upon the impress of our thoughts and our minds to create a form which is in direct replication or reflection of the thought that goes into it. Why I say that is because, as Tracy's beautiful treatment stated, was the real thing is love. And so when we title this talk, The Real Thing, I just don't want to just talk about love. What I want to do is I want to push it out into the actions of how we think and why we think and what we get back in return in our lives. How many people here have ever done something for someone else in their life and then felt that they were rejected at the end of it and felt maybe perhaps a little bit bad about it? Yeah, a little bit. Like, you know, you give somebody a gift and then they don't even thank you. Or you do something for someone and they don't even notice, they don't even recognize it. The reason that I bring that up is not to bring a downer on this whole crowd, which we're kind of quiet here today anyway. But I do it because what I want you to do is I want to reflect back on the intention or the reason why you gave that gift in the first place, why you did that thing. What I want to do is I want to bring forward here today a tool which is almighty vital for what we want to do and to manifest and bring into being and bring into creation what it is we want to experience in our lives. Have you noticed, for example, that maybe perhaps your life isn't a direct reflection of your thinking? Have you picked up on that? No? Good. But have you noticed that maybe perhaps things aren't happening the way you want them to happen, even though perhaps you're working away at your thoughts to be able to make them to work in that direction? I'm all by myself here today. Okay, that's all right. I can do it. All right, so basically, in my experience, what happens is that I sometimes do things for what I think are the greatest reasons in the world because I'm really not thinking about it. And then I find out afterwards that I'm hurt by it or I have some disappointment that comes out of it. And obviously, I'm the only one in the room that does that, so that's fine. And when I do that and reflect back on the intention behind it, what I discover is that what I'm doing had a hidden agenda wrapped around it in the first place. It had something other than a pure, unadulterated, unconditional, loving effect that went with it. It had some other thing that was attached to it. I give a gift and I expect something in return, even if it's a thank you. Or I do something, I work for someone, or I put myself out for someone and I have an expectation of something in return that doesn't come. And therefore I feel disappointed through that process and through that action. And the only reason that I can feel disappointed in anything in my life is because I'm not getting back in return what I expect to get when I give it back out there. Now are we on the same page? So we find ourselves in a situation oftentimes that what we do is we run into disappointment in our lives around certain things. Now in a couple of days I'm going to turn 60 years old, which, wow. All the 70-year-olds say, big deal. All the 40-year-olds say, wow. And the only reason I bring that up is because I kind of reflect on my life at that particular point. You know, I look at it. I don't know why, and it's not really conscious. It's kind of crept in on me. It's kind of snuck around the corner for me and given me a little bit of a shake. And I'm wondering why I'm so contemplative and quiet and withdrawn this last couple of weeks. And the answer, I think, is that what I'm doing is I'm reflecting on something. And what I'm reflecting on is I'm reflecting on the status of my life at this particular time. And I probably did it when I turned 50, and I probably did it when I turned 40. And the reason is because it's like a milestone year. And it gives me an opportunity to look back and to look at what my agenda was or what my desires were or what my expectations were in the past and see whether or not I've accomplished or brought them into being. And the truth is I brought a lot of them into being. And I brought them mostly into being through unconscious activity and action. But there's one little key and one little tool that I want to share with everyone in this room that has absolutely been infallible for me in the way that I've lived my life and the things that have occurred from it. And from that, when I do it that way, then what happens is perfection inevitably shows up for me. When I do it from another way, when I do it with an agenda, when I do it with that desire, then usually what happens is I meet in some area and some place with some disappointment. Now I certainly don't want to let you think or believe that having an outlined goal to what you want in your life is not the right thing to do. What I do want you to know, though, is that it is dependent upon the intention that you have for what you want to do, and how you operate that intention and work that intention in your life. I remember one of my mentor teachers is Dr. Arlene Bump from Fort Lauderdale now, but she was in Calgary and Glendale before that, so I've known her for a long time. I remember one of the greatest stories, and it's one that I use all the time, that really struck me, and that's after the hurricanes came through Florida a few years ago. It hit her church fairly seriously. It tore the roof off of it and tore all the landscaping out and just destroyed everything around it. And she told me the story of going to her church for the first time after the hurricane had passed through in South Florida, and that she'd gone there with a group of people, and that as she was getting ready to go into the building, she first drove into the driveway, into the parking lot, and looked at all their beautiful landscaping and saw the trees all gone and the plants all ripped up and the concrete broken and heaved here, there, and the next place, and the debris and detritus that was spread all over the place. And she said when she saw that her heart sank. And so she went to the entryway of their sanctuary, which is a nice portico, and she stood in the portico and just stood there. And the people who were with her said to her, "Dr. Arlene, come on, let's go inside. Don't you want to go inside?" And she said, "Yes, I do, but I'm just making up my mind right now what consciousness is going to cross that threshold to go in there. Whether it's the consciousness of, oh, how terrible this is, whether it's the consciousness of overwhelm, whether it's the consciousness of anger, whether it's the consciousness of grief, whether it's the consciousness of loss, or whether it's the consciousness of what she wanted to create and bring into manifestation when she walked in there." That kind of awareness, that kind of being awake and alertness is what brings things to fruition in our lives. It's what creates and draws and attracts into our being. It is the real thing. As opposed to perhaps going and figuring out how you're going to be able to work it out according to your own plan and your own agenda and the own way that you think it should be, or the way that you think that it ought to be, at least. And perhaps you know what I'm talking about. You know, she could have easily shown up at that same place in that same location and said immediately, pulled out a list and started making lists of what it is that needed to be done, how much money it would cost to do it, and make all that litany of ideas of being and doing things and write it down on paper so that it would be in front of her. And those, according to Gary Zukav at least, would be out tensions as opposed to intentions. What they would be is an outer focus in an outer way, when we know that the real thing comes from the consciousness behind the activity and the action, not from the action itself. We know that it is the spirit behind it that creates and draws and attracts and brings into being what it is that we seek, not the activity or the actions. It doesn't mean that that activity is not required. What it means, though, is that the idea behind it is the all-important aspect. You see, essentially what we are is we're idealists in the truest sense of the word. We believe that the essence of anything does not belong or exist in the thing itself, but instead of the idea of the thing. And so because of that, and because that's the way that we operate and the way that we live, we know and automatically, presumably, if we're awake, alert, we automatically go to that place of having that intention be delightful, having that intention be true, having that intention be real, as opposed to having the facts and figures in front of us thinking that that's the importance of what goes on. And there is importance in that. But it's not the way you manifest or make things happen. And each of us, although none of you agreed with me at the time, have proof of that in the fact that there are areas in our life which are unfulfilled. And yet we're aware of those areas being unfulfilled, and I'll bet you anything that you're working diligently on making them be different, on creating and bringing into being a different experience or a different thing. Maybe perhaps what you're doing is you're working in the area of your health, your physical health. Maybe what you're doing is you're working in the area of your relationships. Maybe what it is you're working in the area of your finances, or maybe you're working in the area of how to get a better job or a better creative expression for yourself in your life. And I would wager that what you're doing when you do that, because I know that it's what I do, is what I do is I take it together. I say, let's take finances, for example, and I look at it and I say, all right, what do I want to achieve? What do I want to budget? How do I want to make this work? What can I expect? What is the goal that I'm going to put out there? And I put forward an affirmation that says something to that effect, and I lay it out in front of me, and I start working towards it and start moving towards it. And my experience, at least, and I speak for myself, is while it has great power and it has great pull and it has great value, the way that I can make it work so smoothly and so easily is to be clear on the fact that I'm operating from something that's an intention as opposed to an out-tension. That I'm working from the point of view of knowing why it is that I want the form in my life as opposed to wanting the form in my life so that I can experience the why it is that I'm really looking for. Am I making sense? And so we find ourselves in that situation, or I do, certainly, where I might say, what I want is more money in my life, and I set a figure out there and I start going towards it. But the truth is that if I'm just going towards the money, it kind of stays away from me. It doesn't really operate at the level that I would like it to. Excuse me, you might not be able to see that, but there's a spider hanging right here. He's standing right there now. I'm grabbing things from the audience. And so when I set that into my mind and when I develop that intention with myself, then that brings into being and creates for me the real thing. It creates for me the experience and the expression of being consciously aware, understanding that my consciousness is more important than my resolution, that the thought behind the thing is more important than the thing itself. And so when I look at those areas in my life where it is what I want to achieve a more loving relationship, so I start looking for love in all the right places. There's nothing wrong with the looking for love if the intention behind the consciousness is accurate, which is that I'm looking for a place to share myself. I'm looking for a place to spend myself. I'm looking for a place to find some form of solace and companionship and connectivity and connection with it. And when I do that from that emotional entry, that consciousness behind it, instead of looking at it from a place of saying, I need that to fulfill my life, then the end result is that it's drawn and attracted to me in every activity and every action. Instead of setting out an idea and an agenda and just simply saying, that's what I'm going to do, and trudging forward, I change my idea around it. You know, I'm sure that there are people here in this room, and I'm not going to ask you to put up your hands, who are in a working situation which is perhaps less than comfortable. I know that because I've talked to some of you at different times. And the thing is that as long as you kind of look at that from that point of view, and as long as you try to seek to fix that and make it better, and find the different areas in it that are broken, and then determine that you're going to make that all right, as long as you're operating from that mentality and that consciousness, what you get to do is continue the experience of the discomfort. But the minute that you turn that idea of that discomfort into the realization that what you are doing is spending yourself, and you start working on the only thing you can really change, which is your own being and your own thought process, the minute that you start doing that, what happens is that starts to rearrange itself to fit in perfection who you are, or you start to rearrange yourself so that you no longer have to deal with that. It holds true in love, it holds true in health, it holds true in money, it holds true in work, it holds true even in spirituality. The less I seek my source for some definitive, the closer I am to find. And that's exactly what I want to move, because that's the real thing that we can awaken ourselves to. We can begin to realize that we do things from within, motivated by our own love and our own desire, as opposed to something outside of ourselves. I learned a long time ago that when I do things to try to achieve something outside, that what happens is I live in that state of disappointment on a regular basis. And my life, therefore, ceases to be joy-filled. It ceases to be filled with the light. And therefore, what happens is I become an old crank, and I start sharing off all my negativity, and that draws and brings into my life more of that negativity so that I get to experience it more. As opposed to when I move forward with a dedication within my own soul and my own belief system that says, I'm going to go to work today filled with light and love. I'm going to go to work today filled with joy. I have my ideas, my intentions set in front of me. In the area of finances, it is to live a life of ease, to have prosperity come to me pressed down and flowing over. In the area of health, it is to be vibrant and filled with energy whenever required. In the area of love, it is to draw and spend time with people I love who love me. And in the area of creative self-expression, it is to live consistently and constantly in a state of fulfillment and purpose. And all of those things can be done as opposed to, I need a better job, therefore I'm going to go out and make a better job work for me. I need a greater love life, therefore what I'm going to go out and I'm going to demand people love me. I need more money, therefore I'm going to go out and chase money and do things for money at every opportunity and every place I turn around. And I need to be healthier, therefore putting and drawing, attracting everything into my body to tell me how disappointed I can be in my physical form. When we take that opportunity to be able to work from the real thing as opposed to the unreal thing, when we work from an intention as opposed to an out-tension, what happens is the intention draws and attracts everything required to fulfill it into your life. Because it's doable. Because it's something that fits within the consciousness and the belief system that you hold to be true. Because it's achievable in what you do and how you do it. And because the intention behind it is based on love and light, it's not based on need and want. And that is the process. To be able to switch our minds and switch the way that we think to be able to move into that area of being in that area of our life. So I would have you think what you need in your life. Health, wealth, creative expression, loving relationships. Pick an area. Pick a card, any card. And when you have that area in your mind, I want you to think for a second about what it is that you need to make that area all right for you. What your linear intellectual mind, what your outer mind, what your out intention is about it. And draw and derive that and bring that forward into your being and into your thought. You don't have to share it with anyone, so you don't have to tell anyone about this. But just bring it forward and find within it the agenda that you have wrapped around it. The agenda might look like, when I have more money, I will be happy. As opposed to, I am happy and therefore I get more money. Find that within you. Find that area. Because what you're doing when you're doing that is you are identifying the mental equivalent which is manifesting into the form in your expression. I started this talk by telling you that we believe in an infinite mind filled with potential that acts upon the impress of our beliefs and our thoughts. What I am telling you now is that what you're believing and what you're thinking is manifest in your experience in what you have in your life right here and right now. And that it is not about trying to change that outer. Instead, it's to go back within and to know what it is and change the intention behind the activity and the action of what you think you need to do to make it different. Because when you do that, when you change from trying to resolve an issue to instead having the consciousness of embracing and bringing it into your being, then what happens is everything is drawn to it. Because when I say that it acts upon the impress of our thoughts, what I'm saying is it acts upon the identical impress of our thoughts. Not just our conscious thinking, not just what we want to be real, not our wishful thinking. It acts upon what we actually expect and what we hold within our heart to be true about it. And a lot of us have the experience and have gone through the experience of developing solutions within our minds, and the solutions are the things that disappoint us because they're not coming true the way that we want them to. But I tell you that if you change, just make that slight change of that consciousness and adopt a pattern and an idea in your mind that you are looking at it from a different point of view, you will have a different experience than the one you have right now. So that idea that you've brought forward in your mind, that thought that you have, hold that and look at it. Find what the agenda is behind it, what is disappointing you about not bringing it forward. And when you can trigger on that and feel that, then release and surrender it and turn instead to the recognition and the knowing that your life is what you seek right now. And at that point, what happens is everything is drawn to you. Do you have an idea in your mind what it is? Would you like to treat? All right. Close your eyes and relax. Bring that forward into your focus. Allow it to be present in your mind. Don't be frightened of it. Don't look at it as bad. Don't look at it as wrong. Simply recognize it for what it is. I believe in a power that exists in the universe that's mine to use. I know that I am connected to that power at depth at all times. I know that I create the form of my experience through the body of my belief. Knowing that, understanding that, and grounding myself in that, right here and right now, I mentally picture myself, and you may choose to do the same for yourself, withdrawing and stepping back from the issue that I see before me. I step back from it. I no longer mess with it. I simply accept and expect that there is a power that exists within me, that operates through me, that is greater than the body of my belief, that knows the truth for it. And I allow right here and right now that belief to foment within me without any need to do anything except surrender myself to it and allow that it operates through me. I therefore know that the solution that lies before me for this issue that I have presented already exists within me, that I am the creator of the solution and I am the creator of the problem. And I therefore surrender the problem to that higher mind that exists and operates in me. And I allow the truth to come forward. That truth comes forward in such a way that it is consciously available to me. That I see it, I feel it, I sense it, and I know it. And instead of pushing it away right now, I simply open myself and accept it and allow it to flow into my life and into my being. I change from trying to change the outer effect of my life through the activity of my mind. Instead, knowing that it is born within me, I simply adopt the pose and the recognition of the beauty and the magnificence of it. I allow that this universe works in perfection and that my life is the direct reflection of who I am. I take full responsibility for that without any anger or without any sense of less than at all. I simply know that that power that is who I am transforms and changes that belief and that idea. And with that acceptance in my mind, with that knowledge and that knowing, with that certainty that it will take place, I simply surrender it back into the universal mind, back into that mind which is God, which is all things. I surrender it and I allow it to manifest and know that from this moment forward, that issue is resolved in mind. And that everything that is required comes available to me when I require it and when I need it. I always know what I need to know when I need to know it. I simply await the awakening of my own consciousness to see the intention and the purpose behind my life, recognizing and knowing that that purpose is a purpose that is a gift to the world, that it is me shining my light in all that I do. I release any hesitation to do that. I only do what I am called to do within my own being and my own life. I let go of all other issues and know that it is resolved through my consciousness, not necessarily through my actions. I surrender and let this be my truth with expectation and knowledge, and so it is. Bless you.